in-house bricklaying competition. We run these every year as part of a selection event for skill build. It's a good team building exercise, an individual exercise where they can all get together, build blocks to a very high standard, and we've got seniors, which are level 2 students, level 3 students, who are predominantly fairly skilled and fairly efficient at what they do. They'll do a harder model, which is this model here, senior model. They have 6.5 hours to build that model, and we've got the junior, which are first year students and second year students, but mainly first years, who have an introduction to competitions, and they're doing the 5.5 hour model here, which is fairly, a little bit easier. Skill base is a little bit less, as the more advanced team have a little bit more targeted accuracy. Much more difficult to build. We've got 8 in the senior competition today, and we've got 9 in the junior competition. They'll work hard all day. They'll have a break at lunchtime for 45 minutes. So there's no stopping, it's a full on day, solidly, right through to lunch. And they'll have a 45 minute break, and then they'll go on until juniors go until 3:30, and then seniors go until 4:30. And then the marking, just like a traditional competition, will be marked, takes about an hour to mark the jobs, and then there'll be a presentation at the end of the day, where some prizes, certificates will be given out, and from that we can also look at the scores and select for our score build competition. We also have our local Guild of Bricklayers competition as well, which we'll also select in that. We're allowed to select 2 seniors for skill build and 1 junior, and for the Guild of Bricklayers, 1 senior, 1 junior. So it's a big day for them, because they showcase the skills. So it's not only about the skills, it's about how fast they can bricklay as well. So it's meeting the skill, the standards that we want in a set time, and that's really what puts them. Makes competitions different to a normal model that you do with workshops, because it's a timed event, and they've got to lay a set amount of bricks to a set standard within a set time, and that's the difficult part. So we've got a lot of juniors that are working down here in this area, and we've got seniors that are over there all in one set. Your models, don't worry about that. All I want you to do today is try your best. That's really what I want you to do, because all the student today is give you a taste of what a competition's like. Okay? Some of you will really take to it, some of you will find it won't, it'll be challenging, okay? It'll test your skills, because anyone can do a good job if you've got enough time. What this does is set you against the clock. Alright, and that's the difference. Now, what you're looking for in these competitions is accuracy. Every millimetre you're out, you'll lose a mark, okay? So if you're getting everything exact on your sizes, your plumbing, your gauge, your levels, your face planes, perps, your size of your joint finishing, or I can't measure joint finishing, you will lose one mark for every millimetre you're out. So every plumbing has got 10 marks. If you're 1 mil out, you'll get 9 marks. If you're 2 mil out, you'll get 8 marks. That's how it works. So, that's what you've got to remember when you're coming. Gauging, I'm gauging from 300, 600 to 900. So if you gauge not from top to the top, first across the top, if you gauge periodically off your wall, there's 10 marks for each gauge. Okay? All your sizes square, you need 10 marks for each squaring point, 10 marks for each measuring point. Your jointing, half round flush, recessed. Okay, so what you might not totally have done, you think the jutes have got recessed and there's the other. So you've just got flush and half round. But make sure you keep your bricks neat as marks for keeping it neat. Okay, if you're getting it all, no holes in your joints, just marks for that. Make sure your brick looks nice and clean. You might have to trowel clean in your workstation. Cut your bricks, don't cut right where you're working, cut away from where you're working. Standing on the bricks. You've all got a mat each where your goggles, you lose marks in the competition. Find you when you're cutting your bricks. There's very little cutting in the junior order. There's more cuts some time. Okay.
Thank you.
it in reverse order, okay? So we'll do the junior section first, and it'll be obviously reverse order, third, second, first. Is everyone okay with that? Everyone gets a certificate, and we'll go from there. So we'll start with junior. So, do you want to write Kevin?
Yeah.
Yeah. So if we've got a Cal Chadwick, yeah. Cal Chadwick wants to come forward. On the camera.
Okay.
And also we'll have a signed bottle by Mark Dog. Okay. No, this is before.
Just the ones I've taken off.
Okay. Okay, Kyle, there's your voucher.
Get a breakfast.
In third place for the juniors, we've got Liam Roberts. So welcome, Liam. Now, third place, Liam, we've got you a £10 voucher. And you also get trout. I am. Second place, Stuart Brooksmith. Well done, Stuart. It was very close. It's a fine tooth courage. Well done, Stuart. I went small prizes for you. You're going to have 2 foot level. And the winner of the junior competition is Jack Reeves. Well done, Jack. Very impressed with you, so that's very, very close to Martin. Very much. Okay. Aaron, would you like to come forward, please? Okay. And then, fourth place, we've got Kieran Allen. Do you want to come forward, please? Okay. £5 to spend it. Well done, Kieran. Third place, we've got Nathan Foster. So well done, Nathan. £10 to spend at the shop. Well done. And we've also got well done, mate. Thank you. Okay, second place. Jake, you've all shackled.
Yeah, well done.
And the winner, again, very close, first, second, and third. Out of 508, it was about 30 points. Okay. The winner is Jack Shale. Okay, Jack, well done.
Well done, Jack.